Hello everyone, John Frost with Top Spin Tennis. In this video, I'm going to show you three magic moves for a better forehand topspin drive. Enjoy the video. I have Stan Wawrinka in the video. He absolutely can crush his topspin forehand drive. Let's show you three magic moves that are going to help you implement this shot into your game. Stan has a semi-western grip, so that means his base knuckle on that right hand is going to be on bevel 4 on that racket. Let's kind of try to focus in on that. So yeah, that base knuckle is going to be on bevel number 4. That's ideal. I love that semi-western grip because it kind of gives you that combination of power and topspin on the shot. So let's go ahead and look at that preparation. Let's look at magic move number 1, and that's really going to be that loading phase. If you look here, he really gets into a really, really solid position. Notice how his feet are under him. He's got a great base here, and notice the knees, how they're bent. He's also taking a full shoulder turn, so he's prepped. He's really set this right side. That racket is back, and now he's ready to impart that power going forward. And he's really going to generate the power from the ground up here. So magic move number 1 is just really establish a great base. That way you can bloom where you're planted. All right, magic move number 2 is going to be the path. The path is key here. Notice the racket head, how it starts above the ball, and you can see the incoming ball right here. Look at that racket head. You can see that, well, let's actually get to the point where he drops the racket head right there. So here's the tip of the racket head, and there's the ball. So the path is not going to be steep, but you do want to remember that it does still have to be low to high. This is not going to be a level swing path. So his racket head does drop below the ball. And let's go ahead and look at the approach to the ball. So there it is. Racket head drops. He finds that ball out in front. So there it is. So you want to get below the ball, but you do not want to level out the shot completely. It is going to be a low to high shot. One thing I want you to notice too on contact, notice how the racket head is below the hand in this position. So it tells you that he is coming from low to high on the shot. One other thing for a power tip here, notice his racket head in this position and notice the hand. You want to have that racket head drag behind the ball as long as possible. You don't want to square up to the ball too soon. So he does have a little bit of a lag here, and then he squares up with that ball out in front. The swing path is low to level, finds that ball out in front, and here's magic move number 3. Once you find that ball, we don't want full extension out to the target. What he's going to do here, and this is magic move number 3, is he's going to hit through the ball and then lift up and across. Do you see that motion there? So he finds the ball out in front, and then basically what he's going to do is with this top edge, he's actually going to throw it up to the sky. So you throw that edge, you find the ball, and then he throws that edge up, pulls up and across here, and finishes on the left side of his body. So those are the three magic moves. Love Stan's forehand. It's going to help you a lot. If you haven't done so already, make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and that notification bell as well. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.